Excuse me? Excuse me, sir? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
Oh, no, no. No need to apologize. Sometimes I get so carried away arranging things on these shelves, I don't notice people come in. You know, it's this old bell. Who can hear it? It's just a little ding-a-ling sound.
I don't know, I kind of like it. There's something nice about it.
Well, you know, it's been on that wall for, I don't know how long. A long time, let's leave it at that.
Are you him? You're him, aren't you?
Who do you mean?
You're Naum.
Well, yes, yes, there's some that call me that.
You don't understand. I've been looking for you. I've been looking for you for such a long time.
Everything's relative. Everyone's story is different.
It has been years.
Years? What is a year anyway? Well, it's nothing really if you think about it. Just an arbitrary measure of time. Something that is only significant because we choose to make it significant. How we love to measure and compare and count. When we're young, we long for the years to pass so that we can get older. When we're old, we long for the years that have passed. We're complicated, aren't we?
It has been 18 years since I was a little girl.
Yes, and now you're here.
Finally.
So what is it you come looking for? How may I be of service?
I can't remember.
Ah, I understand. It could be difficult sometimes, the past.
Can you help me remember? Isn't that what you do?
To remember. To find those memories that we thought were lost forever. Yes, I do know a thing or two about that. So think back. There must be something.
I was just a little girl.
No, you were more than that. A very unusual child. Very sharp. Very smart.
I didn't want to leave.
But it was important. The family felt there was no other way.
So that I could have a better life.
Go on. Step down. Step down. Passport, please. Is this your daughter?
Yes.
What's her name?
Zhenya.
How old is she?
She's 10.
Suitcase.
I remember. He didn't seem to care. Garment after garment, he ruthlessly ripped our clothes out of the suitcase. Mama's evening shawl, her tailored suit, my summer dress, all lay scattered on the discolored floor in front of the customs officer.
What are you doing? This is all I've got.
There were so many people at the airport. They looked so nervous, so scared. Everything they knew, everything we knew, we were leaving behind. Next! Next! Passports, please. Your son's with you?
Doroga!
Out of everyone there, she was the hardest to say goodbye to.
Bags.
I mean, first love at 15. It might be childish and perhaps unreal, but at that moment, there was no greater love.
Bag! Get him over here!
Dioja! I kissed her one last time. I swore not to turn around again, but inevitably, I found myself looking back to see maybe she was still waiting for my glance.
Seeing her suffer scared me. How is she going to protect me? Suddenly, I realized how insignificantly small I was. I looked back at my familiar pillar of strength, my father. Back at that gate, he was unable to do anything but smile and
mutter empty words of consolation.
My dad never cried in front of me, but separated by that gate, I saw heartache in his eyes. A deep sadness masked by a plastic smile. There were dozens of faces around him, yelling, crying, consoling, but I just saw his and those big, sad, pained eyes that tried to tell me everything will be all right.
Get him back here!
Can you please put that on the table and open it?
At that moment, our hearts stood still. My mother's violin. I could only imagine how she felt, but for me, all the outside noise became non-existent. I felt like I was submerged underwater, and I held my breath. My grandfather, Ephim, had bought it from an old craftsman. It was carved in the 17th century by a European artisan, his prized possession. My grandfather gifted it to my mother on the day of her graduation from Kiev Conservatory, and he was so proud. His daughter becoming a musician. He carried that thought with him until the day he died. That instrument was my mother's pride and joy. It was the thing that most reminded her of her father, and without it, she wasn't going.
Concerned with filling his daily quota, the officer reached for the last thing of value he could find, my mother's coat. Her collar became unfastened, revealing the symbol of her identity.
A cross? And you married a Jew? What a waste of a Russian woman. Take off your coat. Worthless. Let me see her bag. Нашел!
Our silver spoon. Our family heirloom. He found them. To take them away from us would be to tear pages out of our family history. He knew their value. He didn't care that they were my great-grandmother's wedding present. As a 17-year-old bride, they were the last thing she could have. She used them for every dinner for the remaining 60 years of her life. My family ate with them for generations, lifting soup to their lips for revolutions and wars, watching the silver grow worn and tarnished as they sat around the dinner table and found comfort in each other's company.
The silver is not going.
It's not going.
We have paperwork.
Let me see.
My parents bribed a notary into preparing a carefully crafted passport for the violin. According to the passport, the violin had no great historic or material value. It was just a toy. It could leave the country. But my father knew there was only one way.
Only one way we would leave with the spoon.
Only one way we could leave with the violin.
Money.
The bribes which all the customs officials took on a daily basis were still technically unethical. So if my father wanted to show the customs official his appreciation for her job well done, he had to do it discreetly.
But Mama had nothing to give.
Go!
With the spoon!
Go! Go.
Nothing is ever lost.
But it's just a memory.
Perhaps. But then again, what is it? Isn't everything just a memory? Everything we think and touch. We keep those memories close, because then they continue to live on, continue to exist and become as real to remember them.
What is this? What are we supposed to be doing here?
This is great. I love it. It reminds me of my grandmother's attic back in Moldova. We were always allowed to play with all sorts of old things.
Yeah, well, you know what? The Apple Store has all sorts of things you can play with. Yeah, and all that stuff is new and functional, unlike all this crap. Okay, so...
Daniel, look at this. It's so vintage. I love it.
What are you going to do with that?
We can give it to your parents.
No, my parents don't need that.
This, your mom would love these.
Come on. No, what are you
gonna do? May I help you folks with anything?
Yeah.
Yes.
My parents threw us an engagement party, and we're shopping for a thank you gift. But look, unless you have something from Tiffany or, I don't know, Jonathan Adler hiding in the back, I don't think we're gonna find anything here, you know?
Well, there's no harm in looking.
Right.
Hey, listen, I think I'm gonna take off, okay? I'm just gonna go. Look, here, take my card, and you hang out and browse and look
around.
No,
we were supposed to do this together.
No, I know, but you're so much better at this than I am. Look, just, you hang out and browse and look around and maybe get something for the apartment. I don't know where to put it. Don't get anything for my parents. Look, you browse and hang out. I'm gonna get some coffee, and you just call me when you're done. Okay? I'll see you later.
I love you.
Okay, see you later.
That was interesting.
Yeah. He was just giving me some space.
Well, yes, of course, space. So, an engagement party, that's exciting.
Yeah.
When is the wedding?
Spring.
Oh, wow. That's soon. You must have everything figured out. The dress, the reception hall, the music. Huh?
I'm wearing my grandmother's dress.
You know, I might have something you will really like. Tiffany's, but...
This music, what is it?
It's from the old country. Vintage, you might say.
I love it.
Song.
Yes, it was lovely.
And you danced beautifully.
Thank you. You always give me compliments. Why is that?
Because I admire you, because I think you're great. Are you here alone? Where's Dimitri?
Somewhere. I'm getting some fresh air, I guess.
And left you to dance by yourself? That's no fun. The music is playing again. Dance with me, Sheva.
I can't. Dimitri wouldn't like it.
Just one dance. comes, I'll just tell him I was keeping all the other boys away.
There's no way to know.
That's not good enough.
I found it, that's all. There's nothing more.
And what now?
What now?
What happens now? I don't know how to be.
The war is over. Life goes on. Everything goes on.
Things are different now. It's not that simple.
It won't always be this way.
He's gone, Yasha. I'm a widow. That's all I am.
You're a widow, Sheva, I know, but you're here. You're speaking with me. You're a living, breathing woman. Don't act as if you've ceased to exist.
What am I supposed to do?
Mourn him. Remember him for all that he was to you.
And then?
One step at a time, no? I'll be here for you.
Why?
I love you. I always have.
Love me? You don't know me. You don't know anything about me.
I know you. I know that you're beautiful and kind. I know that you always put others before yourself. And you love to dance. I know that you love to dance. All those letters that I wrote you from the front, through them I imagined that you were near me, that you were speaking with me. I remembered our dance.
You remembered our dance?
Of course.
Talk to this guy the whole time. Wait.
This veil.
This? This old veil. For our wedding? You want to wear this at a wedding? You're not serious. I mean. Hey, okay. Look, Maria, if you really want to, no problem. I can get into an old veil. Yeah. Just go home, okay? Come on.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Mom. Maria! Maria!
Naoji.
Hey, what are you still doing out and about? Should have gotten home a long time ago.
Another long day at the office, you know how it is. These business types with their new ideas, long conversations, they never go home.
You ever hear anything interesting?
I hear many interesting things.
I hope you're being careful.
You know I'm always careful.
I'm just saying, it could be dangerous to be involved with a man like that.
Men like that, they're harmless. They're just trying to make a little extra money. There's nothing wrong with having nice things. A new watch from Switzerland. No, can you imagine you wearing a brand new watch made by the best watchmakers in the world? Why shouldn't we be able to have nice things like that here, huh? Or a mink coat. I've always wanted a mink coat. Don't I deserve to have nice things?
There's often a difference between what we deserve and what we have.
Like the difference between mink and beaver.
Yes, my dear, yes. Just be careful dealing with men that think that they deserve more than this country has given them. Men that look around and think, there must be something else.
The society does not treat these men very kindly. Sooner or later, they get noticed by ugly, jealous eyes. And then, my dear, a man like that, he disappeared.
Oh, it's so sweet of you to be worried for me. But they'll be fine. They always find a way. Now, enough chit-chat. Those fine young gentlemen are waiting for me in the next room, and they're in need of a little extra vodichka. No. Can you oblige?
For you, yes, of course.
Oh, no. Do you want to with me? Come on. This isn't easy work. Girl needs a little extra pick-me-up.
Your health, my dear.
Ah, two nice things.
Putting up what's wrong, show me one thing.
I don't know, man. You're staying where you're going, but either way, I'm keeping the dress. That's my man. That's in my mind. Hey! Darling, where have you been all my
life? Not too far.
Have you ever seen a woman like that? Just look at her. She's just... Have you ever seen a woman at all? I don't know if you've ever...
Don't worry, I don't bite.
Oh, you have to pay extra for that.
That's right.
Hey, listen, darling. Since you're already here, could you do me a huge favor? Could you come and sit and play with me for a while?
Yes, I could come sit and play with you for a while.
Thank you. What would I do without you? No. Here's what I'm going to need you to do. Hold the cards. Get nice and cards.
All right, here we go.
Hold the cards.
I'm holding.
Okay. Now, look at these guys here. My best friends, these guys. Fortunately, we're going to be doing cards today.
Yes, okay.
Look at them, look at the cards, and then whisper in my ear, in or out. Well, got to do what a lady says, huh? What do you think about that, Mishka, huh? Whoa!
Big spender.
Big spender. I am shaking in my boots. Now, what about you, Mika? I can't play with you guys. You'll leave me broke. Listen, just wait for Sasha to get here. You can skim some off of him. Plus, he's not a sore loser like you are. So... Mishka, as usual, it's you and me. But this time, I don't feel too good about your chances, you know, because I've got my lady luck right here. So, drop him, baby. Huh? Beat that! What you got? Ha! What Jew magic spells are you casting, huh? Your grandfather's ghost is helping you win, right? Yeah, thank him, because he helped you. Do you know about his grandfather?
No.
Legend has it, this guy's grandfather once cleaned up in a card game with two Russian generals and a naval commander, and that was before they let Jews in the gambling halls, alright? The guy wasn't even in the army in the first place. What was he, a fucking painter or something, right? And he still hustled with the best of them. It was incredible.
Really?
I'm just surprised he never got shot.
He died young anyway. From what? Tuberculosis.
Well, you know, if the smoking and the drinking doesn't get you, the cold air will, every time. Boys, to life. L'chaim.
Zdrovye. L'chaim.
I'm sorry about your grandfather.
Thanks.
Girl, listen, could you go upstairs and get us some more vodka, please?
Of course.
Thank you. You're the best. You're really the best.
No problem. You know, you can't win without me.
Well, then hurry back. And listen, if you see Sasha, tell him to get his ass up here, because Nika wants to win some money back, huh?
Yeah.
I'll
do my best.
Oh, she always does do her best.
Why, Mishka? Why do you have her around? You know she doesn't belong here. What? Because she's fun, that's why. And because she's a hell of a lot better looking than you two. So.
And you trust her?
Yeah, look, why not? As long as we keep making money, she benefits too. It's perfect.
Until someone else comes along who offers us something better. Like a nice KGB man.
Come on, Mishka, stop being paranoid.
I'm only stating the obvious. You can't make any money in this country anymore without someone throwing you in prison. Thanks to Brezhnev and the fucking stick he has up his ass.
Brezhnev is too busy polishing his little medals and working on his scalp to worry about us trying to make money. Okay, here, I've been working on it. Here we go. Tell me if I look like him.
Comrades, today we face a grave threat to the security of our dear motherland.
He's good.
You laugh. Well, you know what the penalties are for our business activities. They categorize all the time. Undermining the economic stability of the Soviet Union. Economic espionage. Treason.
Treason.
Call it what you want. They all carry death sentence if convicted.
That's mad. That can't be true.
It doesn't matter if it's mad. Madness has never stopped them before. Why would it stop them now? They don't draw any lines up on the madness. It's all the same to them.
Gentlemen, look, let me tell you what we're gonna do, okay? We're gonna keep profiting handsomely and bribing the necessary cavemen to keep their mouths shut. And then at the end of the season, we retire quietly to our dachas, okay?
There's that dirty word again.
What, dacha? Profit! Yeah, profit! I said it, you heard me. It's quite a nice word if you think about it. You know, it rolls off the tongue quite easily. You know what? Let me tell you something, Nika. They are fools, okay? They are goddamn idiots if they think that man can be conditioned away from his most natural impulse, his instinct, to work for profit. Huh? For profit, boys.
For profit.
You will never convince anyone of that. Didn't you hear?
What?
We're living beyond history. Mother Russia has created a society of imbeciles who work for porridge and bread. And that's enough of them. Can you imagine them walking around with their smiles plastered on their faces, their dim eyes just pinpoints of light?
That was so wonderfully poetic, Mishka. I never knew you were a poet. It's just beautiful. But you know what? Since we're busy playing cards and not writing sonnets, maybe we can just focus on the task at hand, okay?
Robbing Nika every last time.
Hey, Sashka!
Dorogoy, guten Tag, shalom, privet. Tell me where you've been, please.
Sorry, boys, the wife wouldn't let me get away.
I told you not to get married.
Well, it's too late now. I should have listened to you earlier.
What's wrong now?
She's paranoid, you know?
Your bad influences, they'll get us all in trouble. This will all end terribly.
And to enter her anxiety, she's still hung up on that thing that happened to Yuri a month ago.
Well, first of all, it's a great impression of your wife. And second of all, Yuri was a political agitator. A refusenik, and Yuri dealt in black market diamonds, okay? You never mix business with politics, and Yuri got sloppy. And that's why the big bad men came to get him in the middle of the night.
Look, it doesn't matter what I tell her about him, she still brings him up. And this whole refusenik thing, huge pain in the ass. Whether you like it or not, you get pulled into this whole political agitation of thing by the virtue of your genes. More eyes on Jews, more sneaky little moles running around the motherland trying to do good for their country by renting people out. Can I blame her for being worried?
Nick, how's it feel for you, as a Russian, to be in the company of men like us, who are being eyed suspiciously not just because of our business activity, you know, but also because of our very genes? Huh? How's that feel for you?
Well, I've never met a Jew who couldn't get himself out of a tight spot. I have to say, I feel I'm in especially good hands.
Well, listen, that's good, because I have to tell you, we talked it over, and if this all goes to shit, we're gonna hide you in Sasha's luggage. We're gonna take you to Israel with us, okay? We're gonna have you declared a righteous Gentile.
Look, if you ask me, they should shut all the refuseniks up and send them away to Siberia. I don't care.
They don't want to go to Siberia. They want to go to the Holy Land too. Listen, we could all use a few more pious men praying for our souls.
Okay? They're a nuisance and making it difficult for the rest of us.
Sasha, where is your Jewish pride, huh? We have a land of our own. It's a land of milk and honey. And I don't know what that means. But the important part is that we're beating up all those big bad Arab countries twice for good measure. Sasha, we're the toast of the town. Even Nika's a prouder Jew than you. Come on.
Look, they're not doing anybody any good. We get by keeping a low profile, keeping our heads down. Incoming the refuseniks, making all the noise, bringing attention to the rest of us. It's uncivilized.
This whole country's uncivilized. It's always been that way.
Come on, you can't say that. We're a superpower. We stretch from Europe to Asia. We brought science and culture to the entire world.
You can have your Jewish pride, but where's your Russian pride?
My Russian pride?
What do I have the motherland to thank for? If I'm so Russian, and we're all living in this wonderful communist utopia of equality and love, then why does my passport tell the world that I'm a Jew? Why is my niece, the smartest one in the class, prevented from going to university? My pride? They should be ashamed of themselves.
You have to understand their position.
Oh, really? And what's that?
If they let all the Jews go to university, it's as if they'll be wasting resources on them, because eventually all you guys will move to Israel or America anyway.
Do you believe all the crap that comes out of your mouth, Pay?
Yes. Can we please focus on the task at hand here? The stakes are very high now, and we have a game to play, and we need to save all this energy for cards, all right? Now, Mishka, my love, can you please deal us one more hand? I have to tell you, boys, I got a really good feeling about this one. I do. I'm just warning you, you know, in case you're thinking of making any big wagers. I mean, look, I can't tell you to stop betting your money. Bet it if you want to. It is a game, after all, right? And that's the way the game is played. You win some, and you lose some. What I'm saying is, you guys are my very besties. And I don't want to see any of you be disappointed, you know? I don't want to see any of you suffer. Sash, I don't want your wife getting mad because you came home broke and drunk again, right? I mean, don't say I didn't warn you. This might sound a little unorthodox, but have you ever known me to play by the rules? Right, Nika? I mean, have you ever known me to sit idly by and let the rules dictate how I should live my life? I'm my own man. I've always been my own man. Misha, you can attest to that. Your grandfather's spirit is with me on this end. I can feel it. The spirit of all our people, all those that came before, they are here with us in this room. They guide me and they protect me. And I'm sorry for the rest of you, you know? I'm sorry that they're on my side, and the rest of you are so very alone.
It's time.
Sasha!
No. He's gone. They're all gone.
But what do you mean? They were just here a moment ago.
A moment could be nothing. But it could be everything. Some moments we replay in our lives because that's all we have left.
No, that's not right. We always find a way. Always.
You win some, you lose some. Isn't that how it goes? You said it yourself.
What? We deserve so much more!
The tram is just running late. She'll be home soon.
But Papa, it is 2:30. She's never this late. And she's pregnant. I don't know.
Please, calm down. She'll be fine.
Okay. Can you at least have lunch with me, please?
Okay.
You guessed her. Where have you been? We're both worried.
Baba! Dora! It's happening. We're going to Pierre. We're going? But how? I got 3 tickets. The last train leaves in 3 hours. I borrowed a suitcase from a neighbor. Let's go.
Where's we going? I'm so happy. I need to get this.
Wait, what do I pack?
It's Siberia, what do you think?
Okay, I have sweaters and scarves. Take a hat too, it's cold. Papa, why are you sitting down? Come on, come on, we don't have much time.
I have nothing to pack.
You're not going in your slippers, are you?
I'm not going anywhere.
Are you serious? We've been ready for months now. Did something change?
Nothing has changed. I decided to stay.
Dora?
Papa? What's going on? Are you hungry?
Papa, you know we have to be there for your desk. For your grandson who's hundreds of kilometers away, already waiting in Pern.
Papa, and for your unborn grandchild, we're a family.
Papa, what's going on? We've been ready for over 6 months now, even more since Mama died. I fight tooth and nail to get these tickets for us, and you're staying?
Dory, can you please get us some water?
Of course. Papa. Do you not understand that we're going to die? We have to leave Kharkov. The front is moving closer every day. They will be here tomorrow or the next month. But I can promise you one thing. The Germans will be knocking on your door sooner or later. And once they do, you're not going to be able to entertain them with your stories and treat them to vodka and kolbasa. It's not going to work this way with them. I promise you.
Don't be ridiculous. I was here in 1918. I'm not afraid of them. They weren't after civilians. Germany is a decent nation of civilized people.
Are you serious? Have you lost your mind? It's not 1918 anymore. The Germans are after the Jews. You've heard the same stories I have. They strip people of their clothing, their dignity, their freedom. They force people out of their homes, their jobs, their families. They treat them like cattle, brand them with yellow stars.
Rumors! You're an adult. When are you gonna stop listening to gossip like a little girl? Besides, you expect me to just pack up and run away? Who is going to take care of our home? Who is going to take care of our finances? Who is going to take care of your mother? You expect me to leave her?
Papa, she's gone! Voila!
Delicious lunch for all, Katleta and Kasha, just the way you like it.
Papa, it's just us. We're one family. Mama would have wanted us to stay together. Besides, think about the future. Think about your grandchildren. Your grandson is waiting for us in Pyrmont, your second one. He's on the way. Don't you want to watch them grow?
We are still one family.
Dad, lunch is getting cold, and I know the both of you are hungry. How do you eat?
I'll have some water.
Of course.
And you? I know you're hungry as well. I'm not letting the little one not eat. Look at you. You've gotten so big.
I'm the skinny one now.
Hey. Do you remember our song? The one we used to sing on the porch at night when I had to stay home with you?
Yes, and I used to steal cigarettes from Dad's coat pockets.
Yes, город, который
чорне море явившися мені, звітущі акації гора, звітущі акації гора, у чорне море.
What does it feel like something is ending?
What do you mean? Дорочка, darling,
what's wrong? Be safe.
What do you mean?
I can't leave him.
No, you have to convince him.
He's not going anywhere, you know that. Once he puts his foot down, he's as steady as a rock.
Stubborn as a rock.
I can't leave our old man by himself. He loves his land, he loves Mom. Someone's gonna have to take care of him, cook for him, watch out for him. And besides, you have children to take care of. I promise you, once this is all over, I'll be on the first train to Paris with candy, toys, and knitable socks. Okay, you have to go. I'll help pack your suitcase.
Bob, why do you have to make it so difficult for me?
My feet are planted in this ground, Yudeska. I know each cobblestone on Pushkinskaya Street. I know when to go to the bakery for the freshest bread. I have dinners with my shoemaker's family. I can't leave here. Not now, not ever. I just can't imagine being anywhere else. I can't.
Hey, what's up?
Hey. The train was running local, and Joanne made me stay late again to finish those mock-ups.
Yeah, I just got home a little while ago myself.
Yeah, oh baby, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Did you eat, though? I'm starving. Have you any Chinese food left?
I don't think so. I think we finished it.
Okay. Forget Chinese, then. Pasta. There's got to be pasta, right? What's the suitcase doing in the kitchen?
Is it still packed from Colorado? It was like 2 months ago. We're such sloths sometimes. Seriously, why is it in the kitchen?
Lisa, I quit my job today.
What? Holy shit! Finally, oh my god, was Chris totally pissed? I can't even imagine.
He totally was, but you know, I've had that job for 3 years now. So that's a long time these days.
So? You got another offer?
Not really.
What's wrong?
I'm really not good at this.
No, you're not.
Okay, look. You know that I've had that job for a long time, and lately I've been talking about needing a change.
If you're breaking up with me, just do it.
No! No, 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 I'm taking a trip to Russia.
To Russia? Like, to Moscow or what? I mean, I know you always talked about going, but you quit your job to go on vacation?
Not a vacation, not exactly.
Good, because Joanne's going to give me her time off since Colorado, so.
And not to Moscow, to Kharkov. It's in Ukraine, in the east. But not actually not too far from Moscow. Used to be a part of Russia.
Kharkov.
Yeah, in Ukraine. But it used to be a part of Russia. Not anymore, though. I'm moving there for a while.
What?
I'm moving to Russia for a while.
I fucking heard you. I just don't understand. How are you moving to Russia?
You know that story my grandma used to tell me about being born on the train from Ukraine to Siberia?
Yeah, her mom had to get off the train, give birth, and get back on, so.
Right, so she was on that train because her mother, my great-grandmother, was fleeing from the Nazis. But she had five other brothers and sisters. Some of them fled before the war. One of them stayed in Kharkov to take care of the father. My grandma used to try to make me memorize all their names, but I never could.
Okay, that was like 70 years ago.
I know, but what that means is that my grandmother has all of these cousins she knows nothing about. One of them is 70 and half dead. But she had a son who's 30 and found me online. He lives in Kharkov. Some of them actually moved back after the war, if you could believe it. Anyway, he wants to meet me. I figure I'll go, I'll hang out with him for a bit. He has siblings, I'll bounce around for a little while. This is an incredible opportunity.
This just sounds crazy.
Look, I know what it sounds like, but...
You're just gonna pack up and move to Russia? For how long? So you are breaking up with me?
No! I don't know. No! No! Look, look, it's not about me. This guy, he probably has family heirlooms, books, pictures, stuff no one's even seen since World War II. I have to do this.
Why? Why do you have to do this? Because some Russian asshole got drunk and Googled you? Because some photos from like 100 years ago that may or may not even exist? You have no reason to go and every reason to stay. I mean, you have family here. I'm here. Your job, well, not so much your job, I guess, or do you not care about any of that anymore? This? This is nonsense. And you already have a backpack.
I've been packed for a while. Look, I moved from Kiev to New York when I was 3, and now I'm 30, and I'm probably not going to get a better chance to go back. How could I not go? The most interesting thing about me right now is where I came from. I have to do this.
What's so interesting? They were people just like you and me. What's so damn fascinating?
I don't know. Maybe nothing. But I want to find out.
Isn't it dangerous there? Isn't the KGB still a thing? Secret police coming in the middle of the night? I mean, isn't everyone and their mother corrupt there? You're gonna bring enough money to bribe every cop that you see?
You watch way too many movies.
Oh, and you don't. I'll just pack up and move to a new country. I'll be perfectly fine. Holy shit, Ben, normal people, they don't do that. Exactly how long are you going for?
run out of money? What if something goes wrong?
I don't know! I don't have to know everything!
Look. I know how you're feeling. I do. There's a whole world out there that you want to explore. When I took a semester abroad in Prague, I didn't pack up and move there!
This is so different. I'm not just gonna get drunk in a place with really old churches. You're not even Czech.
And you're so Russian, you can't even talk to your grandma on the phone without stuttering.
So I'll learn Russian. I'll have to. If I want to order a coffee at Starbucks, I'll have to know how to say that.
Yeah? How do you say shitty cup of coffee in Russian? You're not really serious, are you? I mean, how can you just leave? You have everything here. Let's just forget about dinner, okay? Let's just forget about dinner and all of this, and we'll go to bed and we'll talk about it in the morning, okay?
My parents' friends think I'm shy and quiet because I never say a damn thing. By now, they know not to start conversations with me because beyond I'm fine and work's good, there's not much else I can say. My great-grandma fled the war at 25, and my grandma was born on the train from Kharkov to Perm, and the only reason I know where those places are is because I looked them up on Wikipedia. She's told me the story a bunch of times, but I don't even understand half of it. Yeah, and I can keep interrupting her. I could ask her to explain what those words mean, or where that place is, or who that famous name is. Or I can just go. I want to understand it. All of it. I want to take it all in. And I can't do that here. Not really. And I couldn't think of any other way to do it except this.
Could have helped you pack.
I know. Probably did a shitty job. So nervous. Probably packed all like dress socks and tank tops.
That's so like you. You're really serious about going. So not dinner.
Crazy, right? To be looking for a new life when there was nothing wrong with my old one.
I hope to see Father and Dora again and be one family again.
Cousins I've never met living halfway across the world. Can they really become family? Is there more to it than just growing up hearing the same stories?
My son, my Vita, waiting for me in Paris. My heart is longing for you, my baby.
I don't know the first thing I'll do or say. I should be practicing my Russian right now. I have to find out if the most interesting thing about me is worth talking about at all.
I wonder how much he grew up in the past 6 months. I wonder what he's dreaming about at night. Is he eating well?
I wonder what it'll feel like. Will it be normal? Will I feel like I belong? Or will I be a complete stranger?
Oh, baby. I hope I have enough strength left in me. Don't worry, I'm here for you.
Part of the story I do remember, my favorite part, is my grandma being born on that train. She must have been so scared. When I was a kid, there was a saying from her childhood that she used to tell me.
Oh, baby, I would be so happy if you're a girl. You would never have to join the army and go and feel the pains of war.
She grew up hearing it. The first time she heard it was probably on that damn train.
Oh, baby, I would be so happy if you were a boy. You would never need to know the pain of giving birth.
She said she was happy I was born a boy. She said I should eat a lot and grow big and strong and have boys of my own and name the first one Sasha, after her father. I said yes. I told her of course I would. It felt so natural.
I hope to come back to Kharkov after the war. Wherever we end up, I want you and Vita to know where you came from.
Feels so natural.
Excuse me?
Yes.
Are you hiring?
Oh, no. No, thank you. I don't need any help around here. But have a nice day.
Is it really that easy?
Is what easy?
To leave one place, go to another, start from scratch. It seemed like the right thing to do.
You must be new here.
I'm sorry, my English is not so good.
No, it's not terrible.
I'll just keep on practicing and eventually I'll become a real American.
No, there's no such thing as a real American. It doesn't exist.
Back in Russia, that was all I wanted. I wanted to come here and make something new for me, for my family. But now I don't know.
There's a lot of sacrifice to come here.
And for what? I can barely say a word. People look at me like I'm an alien. How will my daughter feel when I bring her here? How will the kids treat her in school? They'll make fun of her. They'll call her names.
You asked before if it was easy.
It's not.
It's not easy. It never is. But the question is it worth it?
I don't know.
You will find out.
Yes, but how? When? I feel that I made a terrible decision, all for a silly dream, to come here and build a better life, a new life for my family. What a fool I've been.
And you would have rather played it safe.
Then I would know what the future holds. More of the same.
And you would have been happy with that.
No. I would have been miserable.
You would have been miserable. Remember this moment. Remember how it feels. The struggle. How difficult it all seems. You came here. You made a choice. Now you have to stop worrying about everything that could go wrong.
Yes. And then what?
We'll see. Here.
Oh.
Take this. Take lots of pictures. Thank you.
husband of hers. How he hasn't starved to death yet, I don't know.
Well, I don't think I've ever heard him speak. I have literally never heard the sound of his voice. She's always shushing him. Oh, and she's always sticking her nose in my business. Oh, Dasha!
I saw you and Misha on the boardwalk the other day. Are you two dating?
Oh, Dasha! I hear you're leaving us to go to Italy this summer, huh? To study law? Or finance? Perhaps to find a husband!
Babushka! Robchik! Oh, girl! Big girl.
Boy, sounds like she needs to find her own husband. What is it, Luba?
I can't find my Robushka and it's time for his lunch. Have you seen him?
No, Luba, sorry we haven't.
Oh, all right. I'll find him in time for your party. I'll bring my Kalendia.
Oh, okay. Poor man. Probably bunkered down somewhere escaping his dinner. That's no way to live.
No.
Stop it, you two gossipers. Leave them alone. Let them be. But that reminds me of last night. I couldn't fall asleep. You know, sweating so much in this heat, as there's no air conditioner in the house. Anyway, I was sitting by the window drinking my tea. Piping hot tea, and Juno should blame me for
having
tea.
I want to hear the story!
And what do you think I see? Dash, do you know?
Flying pig.
Close. I see Alec. You know, the fat one and hairy one from the first floor, climbing out of that floozy Anna's apartment in his underwear. At least he was wearing his underwear.
I'm a fool.
Never seen him move so quickly. And you know what else? I bet that he's going to leave his family for her.
No.
No.
Can you imagine?
Oh, no, but he's got the three kids. Oh, he's always talking about that sick mother of his.
Well, it's nice to hear somebody cares about their mother. And I bet for some people it's not that difficult to leave their families. Mamachka.
Oh, ladies! Preparing for tonight, I see.
Hi, Zoya! Are you coming to the party?
Coming? I'll be the life of the party. I wouldn't miss it.
Nobody will miss her the way she dresses.
What's that?
She says she'll see you tonight.
Such a sweet lady, but I can't for the life of me get over how she dresses. All that leather. Oh, and the one jacket with the fur print and the zippers that she insists on wearing in this 90-degree heat.
Well, you know, we all have our unfashionable moments. This one, for example, let me tell you, the outfit she used to wear in the 70s. Those wide bell bottoms could house an entire family in just one leg.
Yes. I remember those. I wore them to the airport to see you all.
Well, I wish you would have kept them, Mama. The style's back in. I could be wearing vintage right now.
This talk of clothes. So many girls out here, like our dear Zoya with those tight outfits, just trying to catch a man. So glad, Dashinka, that you are not one of them. That you have a goal in your life. My Dashinka, she will take pictures of the entire world.
Entire world. That's a wonderful plan, Mama. Wonderful.
Let me take one now. Okay. So we always remember this. Okay, Mama, move closer to Babushka, please. Come on.
Miles!
No, stop moving. Okay, Mama, say cheese, do something, please. Okay,
this is the wonderful plan. Pictures. Really? That's what you plan to do for the rest of your life, huh? Who's gonna pay for everything? You? What about clothes, food, telephone bills? Pictures are gonna pay for them.
I'm a good photographer, Mama. Good enough to get this internship in Italy.
Oh, and I'm a good enough cook. You don't see my husband hiding under the supper table, but you didn't see me run off to become a chef. Watch out. We have a big shot over here with her unpaid internship in Italy.
Let her go and live her life. It's already decided.
Decided.
If anything, we always can sell my gold teeth.
You always make jokes. You think life is so funny. People get up, leave, and life goes on like normal.
Mama, did you ever listen to your
I always listen to myself.
Well, hey, Lubavushka, Mama, stop already. The tickets are bought, the bags are packed.
I can't with you two. I'm going inside. I have to do my hair.
Am I doing the right thing by going?
Yes, my darling, of course. This is why I came here, for you. For you to make choices, even the choice to leave if you want. Now go, live your life.
But if anything, we sell your gold teeth. By this time tomorrow, I'll be on a plane to Italy. By this time next week, taking pictures of the gondolas. After all that planning, after all that sneaking around behind Mama's back, filling out the paperwork, saving money for the ticket, and then convincing her to let me go. And she finally said, fine, yes, yes, you could go. Not without Babushka's encouragement, her constant nagging. Then how happy were we? I hope I don't disappoint them. I hope I don't disappoint myself. Otherwise, all of these fights, all of these arguments would have been for nothing. I feel so guilty leaving with Mama so upset. But Babushka believes in me. Take pictures of the whole world, she says.
Like it's so easy. Not a care in the world. She tries so hard to be the old, wise Babushka, but she's more naive than Dasha. Not a care in the world, just like she was when she came to America. I begged her not to go. Now she pretends like she doesn't know what I'm talking about. Like everything is always fine. What's wrong with leaving? She says, heck, what's wrong with staying? Why can't we be happy right where we are? She thinks I can't smell her smoking from here. And now she's in Dasha's ear, and Dasha's zipping around the world doing whatever she pleases. What if somebody swipes the camera off her shoulder? Or what if she leaves it in a cab? What if she fails and comes back to Brighton Beach crying? Who's gonna be there to pick up the pieces? I tell you, it's gonna be me again, just like it was when Mama left to America. Who leaves a teenage daughter and putzes off to another country? Who? She blames me for wearing all those old clothes. She wasn't even there to buy any new ones.
Smoking will make your voice ugly like a man's, Janichka.
She doesn't understand that when she left, the whole family collapsed. Everyone knew Mother was in America, but in those days, it wasn't moving. It was defecting. Suddenly, we were the outcasts. The teachers didn't want me in their classrooms. Grandpa lost his job, no one would hire him. All we wanted was to be together, to be a family, to be safe.
Safe? Who says safe is the right answer? Who says safe will make you happy? If not for me, they would have never come here. I wanted you to go with me, but you didn't want to come. I begged you to go, but you could not imagine this new place. Well, somebody had to do it, no? Somebody had to take the bullet so we can all sit and chat in the summertime on the bench. I did this for the family. Somebody had to muddy their shoes on
a new path. My babushka always taught me to follow my intuition, and I will.
I did.
Even when everyone else says, why don't you take pictures as a hobby? Because just like you don't choose where you come from, you don't choose your dreams. And a dream is not a hobby, it's life. It's what you want more than anything. My babushka Raya had a dream to come here more than 20 years ago, and she achieved it. I want that. I want to be fearless. But dreams have something in common with people, too. They can be selfish. Sounds like something Mama would say. I'll see them both laughing, eating at the dinner table tonight, and still the same doubts running through my head. What if after all of these leaps of faith, these selfish dreams, I understand that if she didn't leave us at her wake 20 years ago, we wouldn't be here tonight. Or any night for that matter. And when I came to see you, Mama, I saw how terribly you missed me. I saw how much you changed. I saw that you were a different person. And I'm just afraid with Dasha leaving that I won't be the same for her when she comes back. I'm afraid of coming back with nothing gained in exchange for so much sacrificed. What if I fail?
Fail? What's fail? Maybe after so many years, my English is still not so good. Fail. Oh, now I remember. Fail, it means not to succeed. How ridiculous, like it's under our control. What if I was kidnapped and sent to Siberia the moment I left Odessa? What if my plane crashed?
bad because I don't know how to swim. What if I came here and they said, excuse me, but New York is temporarily closed. Come back next year, please. No, fail is nothing. Fail doesn't matter at all. To live matters. And scared? No. Scared is like fail. I know many scared people. People who all week long wait for a Friday. People who all month long wait for a holiday. People who all year long wait for the summer and all their lives wait for happiness.
Mama.
Huh?
Look, I found this old black and white photo of Babushka.
Which photo? Do I look young? Let me see.
Oh
my, it's the one you sent us when you first came to America, remember?
Babushka, you look a little scared there. Like you're lost or something.
Nonsense. Now let's take another one so you can take us anywhere you go. Now can you smile for this one at least?
Okay, yes, yes. Okay. One. Two.
May I take that? Pictures. Pictures. Everybody loves to look at old pictures. Pick out a photo album. Or God forbid a black and white photo album. And boom, there goes your afternoon. You look at pictures of people you haven't seen in 10, 20 years, maybe never. And still, can't help but ask all the same questions. Papa, where was this picture taken? Or, Mama, how old are you in this picture? Or, Babushka, who is this guy standing next to you with his arm around your waist because it isn't Dedushka? You look at pictures and you can't help but wonder, wow, can you imagine what it must have been like to live like that? To be there? Of course, the answer is no. You can't imagine what it was like to live in the life before you were born. Before Mama and Papa were born. Perhaps the magical black and white time. Don't forget, the past wasn't black and white, but vivid, much like now. We all forget that. And remember again, somebody wise reminds us, then forget again. And that's okay too. Of course, the present, it isn't black and white either. Much more complicated. Many more complicated choices than simple ones. It's a beautiful thing.